German, thanks to the organizer, thanks to all of you for the opportunity to be here and discuss, let's say, crucial issues, crucial meaning the most important issues for the sort of contemporary civilization, let's say. My intention was to ask myself, and now I'm asking you also, whether the existing legal framework, international law and EU law and etc., provide a good opportunity for the resolving existing problems, potential conflicts between the countries in the water management in Southeast Europe. That was my intention. So, since this is not a conference on the legal aspects of the water management, it is not possible to go too much in detail, and that's why I will give just only basic overview of the some relevant issues, and instead conclusion, I will ask myself and you also for some discussions, you know, on this topic. So let me just mention to you several, let's say, relevant issues. Here is some data on the relevance of this topic as the extremely sensitive issue. In the existing literature, if you look at any database, basic data on this topic, you will find a huge number of titles devoted to the security issues linked with the water management. Huge number of titles. Which means there are some dilemmas, some conflicts, some problems in the water management, especially when we're speaking about water management in transboundary context. Anyway, what are the shared resources in international community, society, and etc. What might be considered as the shared resources? We're speaking about water, but what else could be in relation with water relevant? Air, mineral resources, beauty of nature, climate. Climate is shared resources or not? Outer space, life conditions, moral values. Is it our shared joint? All of them, are they linked and how? And what would be the role of norms in this context? Where is the sovereignty of state? Is it fiction, illusion? Yeah. A lot of basic legal issues. When we are talking about transboundary water resources, we are at the same time think and discuss about the several basic keywords in legal theory, in legal practice, in legal normative aspects, etc. Water management, transboundary waters, liability, responsibility, justice, international cooperation, international security, international conflicts, peace, war. Where we are? Groundwaters. Groundwaters are, I would say, out of legal, international legal order, strictly speaking. There are some elements we can implement them, but groundwaters are, generally speaking, omitted from international law, and there are a lot of misunderstood in relation with this. Generally, when we are speaking about dispute settlements, basic position is obligation to seek pacific solution for any disputes in relation with the shared natural resources. That's the basic position. But from that position to the practice, in the international legal foundation, we usually use Article 38 of the Statute of International Court of Justice, and this article enumerated all relevant sources of law relevant for the dispute settlements, including water resources also. Philip Sands has very nice analyzed regarding environmental disputes as the part of water disputes. And I don't have, there are a lot of, several basic, but a lot of, let's say, judicial cases relevant for our discussion, and we can speak about that later on in detail. Here are some characteristics of the environmental disputes. Regarding the soft law, international soft law, all of us knows about Helsinki rules relating equitable utilization of the waters of an international drainage basin. And you can find in these documents almost several decades, in the history of several decades, you can find, everybody can find relevant elements for discussion and in trying to find some solution on the dispute settlement. New York Convention on Non-Navigational Uses of Water Resources also is on the same trace. General principle, obligation not to cause significant harm, general obligation to cooperate, regular exchange of data and information, and relationship between different kinds of use as the crucial elements regarding the dispute settlements. Generally speaking, two basic groups of the instruments, diplomatic and judicial. What is, when we are speaking about dispute settlements, we are usually think about judicial arbitration and International Court of Justice and some other also kind, but we have to have in mind also so-called diplomatic forms of dispute settlements, negotiation, good services, mediation, conciliation, and some kind of commissions formed by the specific international treaties also. All international treaties in environment, in the field of environment, contain almost similar or contemporary international treaties, contain similarly, almost similarly provisions regarding dispute settlements, which means they offer negotiations or any other method of dispute settlement acceptable to the parties to the dispute, which means submission to the dispute of the dispute to the International Court of Justice or arbitration in accordance with procedure set out usually in annex of some of the international treaties. So that's the, let's say, model for the dispute settlement in contemporary international law. What is relevant for Southeast Europe? Convention on Law of the Non-Navigational Uses of International Water Courses and Convention, Helsinki Convention on Water Courses International Lakes, Danube Convention, and Framework Agreement on Sava River Basin. They also, all of those instruments, international law instruments, are
at the same framework, meaning they offer two basic ways of the dispute settlements. However, there are some specifics between, I mean, differences, specific, very, very specific. But generally speaking, there's the let's say, basic model. Instead of conclusion, here is several questions for discussion. Is it possible to expect water disputes in the region of Southeast Europe, West Balkans? Where? What kind? When? What might be subject of disputes? What might be subject of, or cause or trigger? Use water for energy purposes, irrigation, floods and emergency, climate change, communal say what? Does groundwater management can be cause of disputes? Does the existing legal framework provide the basic for the resolution of possible disputes? Is the process of the EU integration of the region's countries a relevant factor? Does it guarantee something or not? Interests are interests. Every country, every people, every population. How will look management of water resources in the future in this region? Who will manage the water resources in the region in future? For example, 2050. Who will be the owners of the water? Transnational corporations? People? State? What does it mean, state? Who is owner of the states? Is it Jean Baudin's theory, people? Or it is something which belongs to the history? Anyway, thank you very much.